Hey guys, for this section, I'm going to be introducing a completely new type of organic reaction, and that's the condensation reaction. So guys, whenever you get two molecules that are spontaneously combining to form a bigger molecule with the loss of a smaller molecule on the side, that's what's called a condensation reaction, okay? Now there's actually tons of different types of condensation reactions in organic chemistry, but the specific ones that we'll be dealing with in this section have to do with enolates. Now remember that enolates are the negative anions of a deprotonated alpha carbon, okay? And what we find is that enolates are gonna be part of the condensation because enolates are so reactive that they're not only just gonna react with electrophiles, as we've talked about in the past, they're also even gonna be able to react with each other or with themselves to do something that's called self-condensation, okay? Now, obviously, due to the fact that there's an enolate-mediated reaction, alpha protons are required for this type of reaction to take place. Because if you don't have an alpha proton, then you're not getting an enolate, right? Because an enolate is the deprotonated version of an alpha carbon, okay? So guys, I wanna just back it up for a second and go back to what we know and use that information to inform our understanding of condensation reactions. So back in the day, guys, seems like the glory days now, we learned about nucleophilic addition. We learned that carbonyls were especially reactive at the carbonyl-carbon, nucleophiles would attack, we would get a mechanism called nucleophilic addition where a tetrahedral intermediate would protonate and we would get an alcohol as a result. Fair, you know, we did that a lot, okay? Now, more recently, what we've learned is that certain types of nucleophiles, specifically basic ones, are going to react at the alpha carbon and take away a proton. So we've noticed that, for example, OH negative can remove an alpha proton and make what we call an enolate anion, a negative charge on that alpha carbon, okay? Well, what's special about that negatively charged enolate is that now we know that it can attack electrophiles. So it could attack some alkyl halide or some halogen, and we can get an alpha substituted carbonyl. Good, awesome. What we're gonna learn in this section is how enolates relate to condensation reactions. And it turns out that same thing, when a base deprotonates an alpha carbon, you're gonna get an enolate. But what happens when you don't have an electrophile to react with? What happens in the absence of an electrophile? So what if I just make my enolate, but then there's nothing to react it with? I never add that other alkyl halide or that halogen. What do we do? Well, in that case, guys, in that special case where there is no electrophile, then the enolate is going to react with itself. What we're going to find is that the enolate is going to react with the non-enolated version of itself, and it's going to do a nucleophilic addition, making a tetrahedral intermediate on the other ketone. Isn't that interesting? So basically, this acts as the nucleophile for another nucleophilic addition, okay? What we wind up getting is a condensation reaction because now I'm taking two ketones or aldehydes, I'm combining them together into one larger molecule. And notice what I would get here, just for this tetrahedral intermediate, what I would get is now R here, okay? And I would get a negative charge, and that negative charge would eventually be protonated. Okay, so this is the product of enolate condensation, okay? And this is what we're gonna be focusing on for quite a few videos. We're gonna be spending a lot of time on enolate condensation, okay? Now I wanna give you guys some examples. This is gonna kind of be a preview of what we're gonna be learning in a little bit, okay? So it turns out that ketones and aldehydes can combine together to make molecules that have alcohol components and carbonyl, okay? This reaction in particular is called an aldol reaction. Okay? The reason being that, as we'll see more later, there's part alcohol and there's part aldehyde. So it's an aldol reaction. Okay? Notice this is condensation because I've got two smaller molecules combining to form a bigger one. Another example, what if we do this with two esters? So we take two esters, we make an enolate, they react with each other. Well, they're going to make a beta dicarbonyl, specifically a beta keto ester. This reaction is called a Claisen condensation. Okay? So this is a preview. You're not supposed to learn these here. I'm just trying to show you guys how we're going to be dealing with a lot of reactions that condensate with enolates. These are two of the most important, but we're going to deal with a lot more in this section. So that being said, I hope the general mechanism makes sense so far. Let's move on to our first condensation reaction.